So hello guys, so in this video I'm gonna show you how we can create product expiry checking notification app using MIT app inventor. So here we go. So as you can see here, I have already created that app, and that's the first screen. So let me show you a step by step how we can create this app and what I have used here. So as you can see here, that's the first screen, right? And in this screen we have used here one text box. As you can see, this is the text box. Okay, second, we have used one date time picker. You will find here in this, here in the left side, date time picker, we have used this. Then we have used here two buttons, that is add to your list and show all products. Okay, this is two list. And in the fifth component, we have used the list view. As you can see in the left side, list view, this. So we have used that list view here. I can change the color also, so you will find you look like this. So this is the list view. Okay, so that's the overall design. It's really very basic, and I have just changed the background color. Okay, now I have used here TinyDB. So in the left side you will find the database, okay, a storage option. So as you can see, the TinyDB is here. So you can use TinyDB, Firebase, CloudDB, anything. Okay, now this is done. Make sure you use the TinyDB. Okay, this is important. The reason is because everyone have to use that app. Okay, this is not a this is not a global database, because if I will save my braid, so, and if I will use the CloudDB, then once you install this app, so you will also see the braid. Okay, so make sure don't use the CloudDB here, use the TinyDB, this one. Okay, now this is the local database. Then now let's go to the block section. Yeah, one thing more, we have used your notifier. In the left side you will find the notifier option, this one. Then to notify the expiry product's name, let's go to the block. So as you can see, this is the first step. Whenever someone click on the button one, so which one is button one? This is the button one, add to your list. Okay, so this is the button one. Okay, now as you can see here, so once the people click on that button one, so we have to store the data. And which data? As you can see, this is the text box one. So here we will put the product name. So suppose we put the braid, and as you can see the braid here, and we need to put the date also from the date picker. So once I click on the date picker, so this will this can choose the date. Okay, but the reason is, like, we have to set that, is like we have to pick that day, month and year from that date picker. So I use like this date picker dot day, then month and then year, and I'm using here the slash. Okay, and using the join to store that value. Done, the value is stored. Now second is what we need to do, we need to initialize one variable to find out the current date. Okay, so as you can see here, initialize global one variable, and I've used here, we just need to fetch the date picker value, current value. So I just use the same thing here like this. Okay, now once I click on the button 2, and which one is button 2? So as you can see, the button 2 is this one, show all products. Okay, so I have added a lot of products. Now I need to see the all products. So once I click on button 2, so as you can see, list view dot elements, call get entries. Get entries means we will fetch the all entries with the name and the expiry date, means the tag value and the value and the tag name, both we will get using this. Okay, so we will have the all thing in a list view. Now we have to use the for each loop. This loop will run until all item will not end, like, you know, until the item ends. Like suppose we have a multiple items in, like maybe the 10, maybe the 15, it can be anything. So that's the reason we have used the for each loop. So as you can see, the for each item in the list, get tags, suppose the get tag is five, so this loop will run 5 times. So if the condition is global today is our current date, suppose today is 28 29, so 29 is equal get tag is item, it means this is the item. Okay, first item, suppose this is a braid, and braid value, we will fetch the value. So value of the braid is the current date, suppose today. So it will fetch the 26, and this will also fetch the 26. So both is equal. If the both is equal, then we will display so message dialog. This one message is this item will expire today, and get item, item name, and this is the okay button. Done. So if that item is not expired, then this will not display this notification. Okay, this is done. Now whenever you open your app, so we call again this get entries. So once I get, and once you once you open your apps, so you will see the all list of your items in the list view. I've used here the when someone click on that list picker item, any item, so you can remove that item just clicking on that. Okay, you just need to click on that item on the list view, and you can remove that. Okay, done. So this is the overall simple and basic code, and this is the amazing app. Okay, so I'm gonna publish this app. Okay, so you can use this. Okay, so publish to gallery and wait some second. So you don't need to worry about AIAX, you can directly use that app. Okay, you fire app in MIT app inventor. Okay, and I just need to just put here the, and yeah, its YouTube channel link is, and more info, nothing, image file. Okay, I have to choose the image file. So what I will do, I'll just take a screenshot of this, and this, it's possible to just drag and drop it here. You're done, and yes, and submit. Next time I will upload the more details on this. Okay, so yeah, it is done. Okay, great. So let me just know if you need any help on that, so I'll try my best to solve your problem. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.